All this talk of goats around here. All I see is sheep in the mirror. Circles getting smaller this year. You make smoke, you're fake, fake woke, fake woke.
World in panic, panic button. Damn, the hand is nothing. Stand for something. Ambulances, damn is coming. Uncle Sam scam the public, can't rebuttal. Plan to damn the man to damn the subtle. Cancel button, hands will clamp the camera puzzle. Channel struggle, can't be muzzled while we sitting shit that can't be shoveled.
Whoever sees this and subscribes right now, get free 5G. Now that's a bar. What's going on YouTube? It's Noxo, and we're back with our reaction series. So today, man, listen. MGK is out here pissing off Joyner Lucas and people while he still continues to drop music and make the hits. And he's got an epic collaboration that I'm really excited to check out. A band that we've never ever done on the channel, so we're going to do this for the first time ever. It's MGK, Bring Me the Horizon, and their song Maybe. But before we go any further, I want to give a quick shout out to the song in the intro. If you guys like that, yes, I'm an artist myself. There's a good chance I like my breakdowns, play that I think about music. You'll probably like my music as well. I have a new album, Blacklist, charted on iTunes for the first time. If you want to support me, support the channel directly, I'll put the links to that below. Also, shout out to the Patreon and Patreon family, exclusive reactions and content on there. If you guys want to join and support, again, all links down there. But anyways, you know what we're here for. MGK, Bring Me the Horizon, step up to the plate. Let's see what you got. He just have different color eyes. Whoa, that's wild.
That's hard.
2, 3, 5.
Okay.
Maybe if I had something to say. Butterfly effect from the last 3 days now. Maybe if I had something.
Bro, all right, I'm from the lace-up era of MGK. All right, I'm used to the fast spitter delivery, the hard raps from MGK. I mean, for me, it's like I'm watching a completely different artist in person. And that speaks to his talent level and his versatility, that he can just dive into a completely different genre, embrace it, and make really good-sounding music. And I love that line. Butterfly effect from the last 3 days. You know, the butterfly effect, like something small happens and it just has repercussions that you can't even see or sense that are just magnified around the world. So something simple that he did may have led to a much greater mistake that he's spiraling out of control from. And I love this setup, man. You've got some nice city shots of London. You got the Shard right there. Obviously, Bring Me the Horizon is a British band.
If I had something to say, butterfly effect from the last 3 days now. Maybe if I had something to save, I used to have a soul until I threw it away. There's shadows.
Maybe if I had something to say, right? Butterfly effect from the last 3 days. Maybe if I had something to save, I used to have a soul till I threw it all away. I love that mirror writing, the way that he sets that up. And then I used to have a soul till I threw it all away. I mean, that's, wow. Talk about feeling hollow. Talk about going off the deep end. That's a tough line right there. Save.
I used to have a soul until I threw it away. There are shadows on the wall, wish I would have ran. Yeah. Gotta get away, I hope you understand. I try to
Who is that? Is that Ollie in the back of the mix complimenting him, or is that MGK doing his own harmonies on top of him? I don't know, but there's a really cool, it sounds sort of megaphony the way it's been mixed. It's been frequenced differently, like stacking on top of MGK's main track. I love the way that sits, man, and that harmony together.
Save. I used to have a soul until I threw it.
And yeah, that's right, I haven't talked about the pink hair yet. Get over it. It's pink. All right, real men rock pink nowadays. I'm gonna dye mine, see what happens, bitch.
There are shadows on the wall, wish I would've ran. Yeah. Gotta get away, I hope you understand. I try to hide my face like a wanted man. Yeah. Maybe I'll be gone before.
I mean, he's still dropping bars in this genre, though. You know, try to hide my face like a wanted man. If you're wanted, obviously, you don't want your face to be seen because you got wanted posters all around.
Yeah. I try to hide my face like a wanted man. Maybe I'll be gone before you count to 10. I made up my mind this evening. I'm taking the last. Drink while my conscience eats me. I'm taking the last. I'm ready to let you go.
Wow.
I'm ready to let you go.
Man, what a hell of a visual, just like taking the shard and literally breaking it apart into thousands of pieces into shards. And I take that as what's going on emotionally and mentally right now, because it matches the lyrics so well, just this chaos within and this darkness. And he's taking one last drink. My conscience eats me. Taking one last drink before my conscience eats me, before it all gets to me. And he alluded to that with the butterfly effect. So obviously something's happened that he's done, that he wishes he could take back, but he can't. And now he's dealing with the repercussions and the effects of all that. And the hook reflects that. And then this just coming apart of the building in which they're playing. That's dope, man. Last, I'm taking the last. I'm ready to let you go. Nice, I love that guitar riff. Maybe if we went another way, I wouldn't be regretting the decisions that I made. Wow, there was a cool sort of distortion. I don't know if that bounced off of the guitars or what that was. It just hit both sides of the mix when Ollie came in. Ready? Did he say, I think he said way, and they like vocalized it and they ran it through like a guitar amp, and then that bounced off of the sides of the mix. That was dope. Maybe if we went another way, I wouldn't be regretting the decisions that I made. I don't want to spend another day. So maybe if I went another way, I wouldn't be regretting the decisions that I made. See, it all relates around sort of this one moment and wishing you could go back and change that, and then the aftermath of it all. Wouldn't be regretting the decisions that I made. I don't want to spend another day. Wow. Listen, man, I know I've made my jokes, I've trolled over here, but this is a hit. I mean, you can't argue with what MGK is doing. I mean, collabing with Bring Me the Horizon, like Youngblood we've covered on this channel, like he just continues to work with these other great artists and big names, and all we're getting is just hit music from it. I mean, the man continues to climb. Come on. Ready to let you go, because you had a little bit more of the sort of relationship story introduced in that second verse by Ollie, and you know, talking about, you know, I'm tired of trying to find someone to replace you, you know, put me out of my misery because I can't deal with this hurt. So obviously that mistake that we've alluded to in MGK's first verse obviously relates to a relationship and maybe the breaking apart of that relationship, and now we're dealing with that emotional fallout and that chaos within and trying to deal with ourselves and feeling like our own worst enemies, and we can't go back and change that past. So what do? We just let go, have a drink, and numb it all. This time is the last. This time is the last. Ah. Oh. What a hell of a line right there. We were built to fall apart. Whew, talk about the glass being half empty. I can't feel you. But it's too late now. There's no point screaming. And he literally just screamed, and he used, you know, that range of his scream vocals. I was wondering if we were going to get some of that more, you know, metal hardcore that Bring Me the Horizon is noted for. And we got it right there. I mean, it's a different talent and it's a different skill set to achieve that guttural sort of screaming, and you really got to work on your vocal cords to do that. So I think it just speaks to Ollie's ability and his just massive range singing wise to jump so seamlessly from the screaming back into the main part of the lyrics. Is that MGK just doing like these little sort of hums to fill out the space and the atmosphere of the mix? I think so. That's cool. Whoa. Love that. I'm taking the last, drink while my conscience eats. Oh. What was that he just did with one eye open and then closed it? Wow. What an adrenaline rush. I mean, what a ride, man. I felt like, I've described this before about some of the other stuff that we've covered. It just like punches you in the mouth and just takes off from there. And you can't even process what you've just been hit with. It's such a roller coaster ride with the production, man. And now I understand what happened with Joyner Lucas. I mean, he heard this song. He's like, damn. This man is a superstar at this point. I can't even touch him. I'm just kidding, man. But I really enjoyed that track. I really enjoyed this synergy. I mean, you had beautiful moments there when they were both singing together. And it just fit, didn't it? And it was like, it didn't feel like two completely different acts on a track. It felt like the same act on the track. Just that synergy and chemistry between them, man. I really enjoyed it. That's right. I'm going to go listen to that again. Listen, MGK, around here, boy, you were Knox Hill certified. Bring me the horizon as well. You are also Knox Hill certified. Thank you guys for watching today's video. As always, be sure to smash that like button. Listen, if you're here at the end, obviously enjoying the content. Do me a favor, support the channel directly. Subscribe, notifications on. As always, just a reminder, stay safe, stay positive. It's Knox Hill. Catch you again. I'm out.